still awake.
Okay, there's 10 cc's. You got 10 more to go.
Oh, yeah.
9, 8.
So close. I can make
push,
it.
Push. I'm going to get that funny taste right now. Okay.
Oh, man, I'm getting dizzy.
I was on YouTube trying to find some videos related to general anesthesia, and this video pops right in front of me, and I could not resist opening this and making a video for you. This says, guy knocks himself out with propofol for surgery. So this is just a cool video someone sent to me. If you know who it is or want to take it on, let me know. It read a little weird to me as to why someone would put it, but however, since this is an anesthesia video, I'm going to play this right next to me and we will watch this together, and the fun begins now. Namaste and welcome. I'm Dr. Rajiv Iyer, a child anesthesia specialist doctor. Let's watch the clip now. Alright, we are in the operation theater and they say it is recording. Now that's the anesthesia doctor who is actually putting a blood pressure cuff on the right arm. He put what is called as a pulse oximeter, which now most people know because of COVID. This is an instrument used to measure oxygen saturation, and usually the range is somewhere between 97 to 100. He put the pulse oximeter clip on the index finger. If you are a junior doctor watching this, or if you are an anesthesia resident watching this, the recommendation from the Anesthesia Patient Safety Foundation is to put the pulse oximeter on the ring finger or on the fifth finger. And this is done to prevent any hitting of the eyes, which can actually lead to corneal abrasion. Usually the reflex is taking the index finger on the eye, and this happens when we see patients waking up from anesthesia. Now the doctor is actually attaching the propofol to the syringe. He asked the patient to push propofol. Okay, propofol is going in. So the question is, can patients give propofol to themselves? Usually not, but this does happen in practices where anesthesia is given to children, especially for cancers. This is because these children tend to come to have anesthesia so many times, and they do have cultivated their own experience, and they just want to do it. And we as anesthesia doctors are really respectful of what they ask. And if they ask for, can I push the anesthesia medicine? Sure, we do let them to do it. And then they start pushing. Of course, the anesthesia doctor is right there watching them, making sure the patients are safe and comfortable. So I assume this might be what something is going on, and this is not unusual for the patient to push propofol on their own. And let's see, he's still pushing it.
Okay,
some people do say they actually taste propofol in the mouth. I have had propofol myself. I did not go through that experience. If you did have that experience, do comment below what your experience was. Alright, now the patient is off to sleep. Now the anesthesia doctor is showing what is called as the laryngeal mask airway. This video was posted in 2015, but the laryngeal mask airway looks like what I used in the late 2000s. So that's a silicone-based laryngeal mask airway, which is not in use anymore. Most of the laryngeal mask airways that I have seen are disposable and are made of plastic, and they look a little different. But conceptually, they work the same way. Okay, he's getting the laryngeal mask airway in. So the eyes is still not taped. So if you're a junior doctor watching this, I would suggest to first tape the eyes before you put the laryngeal mask airway, so you minimize the chances of injuring the eyes. Okay, he's checking that the laryngeal mask is seated in the right position. And he's putting the electrocardiogram on. You know, sometimes the electrocardiogram is put after the patient is given anesthesia, mostly in children, depending on certain situations, but usually the recommendation is to put the electrocardiogram much before. Do check this link out for other videos related to anesthesia and operation, and I have left the link in the description below, and do check them out. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to comment below. I'll try to get to you as soon as possible. Thank you for watching. Take care, stay safe. I'll talk to you soon.